Are you worried that, as a vegetarian and vegan dieter, you might lack sufficient protein? Are you interested in increasing your plant protein intake? Hi, my name is Dipeng. And in this video, you will learn what is the best protein source for vegans and vegetarians. But before that, please subscribe to this YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get notifications for new videos. And don't forget to get instructions on how to get your free guide for losing weight at the end of the video. Many experts agree that a well-planned vegetarian or vegan diet can provide you with all the nutrients you need. Certain plant foods contain significantly more protein than others. And high-protein diets can promote muscle strength, satiety and weight loss. In this video series, you will get 17 plant foods that contain a high amount of protein per serving. Number 1. Seitan. Seitan is a popular protein source for many vegetarians and vegans. It's made from gluten, the main protein in wheat. Unlike many soy-based mock meats, it resembles the look and texture of meat when cooked. It contains about 25 grams of protein per 100 grams. This makes it the richest plant protein source on this list. However, seitan should be avoided by people with celiac disease or gluten sensitivity. Number 2. Tofu, tempeh, and edamame. All three items are originated from soybeans. Soybeans are considered a whole source of protein. This means that they provide the body with all the essential amino acids it needs. Edamame are immature soybeans with a sweet and slightly grassy taste. They need to be steamed or boiled prior to consumption, and can be eaten on their own or added to soups and salads. Tofu is made from bean curds, pressed together in a process similar to cheese making. Tempeh is made by cooking and slightly fermenting mature soybeans, prior to pressing them into a patty. Tofu doesn't have much taste, but easily absorbs the flavor of the ingredients it's prepared with. Comparatively, tempeh has a characteristic nutty flavor. Both tofu and tempeh can be used in a variety of recipes, ranging from burgers to soups and chilies. All three contain iron, calcium and 10 to 19 grams of protein per 100 grams. Number 3. Lentils. At 18 grams of protein per cooked cup, lentils are a great source of protein. They can be used in a variety of dishes, ranging from fresh salads to hearty soups and spice-infused dals. Lentils also contain good amounts of slowly digested carbs, and a single cup provides approximately 50% of your recommended daily fiber intake. Furthermore, the type of fiber found in lentils has been shown to feed the good bacteria in your colon, promoting a healthy gut. Number 4. Chickpeas and most varieties of beans. Kidney, black pinto and most other varieties of beans contain high amounts of protein per serving. Chickpeas, also known as garbanzo beans, are another legume with a high protein content. Both beans and chickpeas contain about 15 grams of protein per cooked cup. They are also excellent sources of complex carbs, fiber, iron, folate, phosphorus, potassium, manganese and several beneficial plant compounds. Add beans to your diet by making a tasty bowl of homemade chili, or enjoy extra health benefits by sprinkling a dash of turmeric on roasted chickpeas. Number 5. Nutritional yeast. Nutritional yeast is a deactivated strain of Saccharomyces cerevisiae yeast, sold commercially as a yellow powder or flakes. It has a cheesy flavor, which makes it a popular ingredient in dishes like mashed potatoes and scrambled tofu. Nutritional yeast can also be sprinkled on top of pasta dishes or even enjoyed as a savory topping on popcorn. This complete source of plant protein provides the body with 14 grams of protein and 7 grams of fiber per 28 grams. Number 6. Spelt and teff. Spelt and teff belong to a category known as ancient grains. Other ancient grains include einkorn, barley, sorghum and farro. Spelt is a type of wheat and contains gluten, whereas teff originates from an annual grass, which means it's gluten-free. Spelt and teff provide 10 to 11 grams of protein per cooked cup, making them higher in protein than other ancient grains. Both are excellent sources of various nutrients, including complex carbs, fiber, iron, magnesium, phosphorus and manganese. Spelt and teff are versatile alternatives to common grains, such as wheat and rice, and can be used in many recipes ranging from baked goods to polenta and risotto. Number 7. Hemp seed. Hemp seed comes from the cannabis sativa plant, which is notorious for belonging to the same family as the marijuana plant. But hemp seed contains only trace amounts of THC, the compound that produces the marijuana-like drug effects. However, hemp seed contains 10 grams of complete, easily digestible protein per ounce. That's 50% more than chia seeds and flax seeds. Number 8. Green peas. The little green peas often served as a side dish contain 9 grams of protein per cooked cup, which is slightly more than a cup of milk. What's more, a serving of green peas covers more than 25% of your daily fiber, vitamin A, C, K, thiamine, folate, and manganese requirements. You can use peas in recipes such as pea and basil stuffed ravioli, Thai-inspired pea soup or pea and avocado guacamole. Number 9. Spirulina. This blue-green algae is definitely a nutritional powerhouse. 2 tablespoons provide you with 8 grams of complete protein, in addition to covering 22% of your daily requirements of iron and thiamine, and 42% of your daily copper needs. Spirulina also contains decent amounts of magnesium, riboflavin, manganese, potassium, and small amounts of most of the other nutrients your body needs, including essential fatty acids. Number 10. Amaranth and quinoa. Although often referred to as ancient or gluten-free grains, amaranth and quinoa don't grow from grasses like other cereal grains do. For this reason, they're technically considered pseudo-cereals. Nevertheless, they can be prepared or ground into flour similar to more commonly known grains. Amaranth and quinoa provide 8 to 9 grams of protein per cooked cup and are complete sources of protein, which is rare among grains and pseudo-cereals. Number 11. Ezekiel bread and other breads made from sprouted grains. Ezekiel bread is made from organic, sprouted whole grains and legumes. These include wheat, millet, barley and spelt, as well as soybeans and lentils. 2 slices of Ezekiel bread contain approximately 8 grams of protein, which is slightly more than the average bread. Sprouting also seems to increase the bread's soluble fiber, folate, vitamin C, vitamin E, and beta-carotene content. Number 12. Soy milk. Milk that's made from soybeans and fortified with vitamins and minerals is a great alternative to cow's milk. Not only does it contain 7 grams of protein per cup, but it's also an excellent source of calcium, vitamin D, and vitamin B12. However, keep in mind that soy milk and soybeans do not naturally contain vitamin B12, so picking a fortified variety is recommended. Number 13. Oats and oatmeal. Oats are an easy and delicious way to add protein to any diet. Half a cup of dry oats provides you with approximately 6 grams of protein and 4 grams of fiber. This portion also contains good amounts of magnesium, zinc, phosphorus, and folate. Although oats are not considered a complete protein, they do contain higher quality protein than other commonly consumed grains like rice and wheat. You can use oats in a variety of recipes ranging from oatmeal to veggie burgers. They can also be ground into flour and used for baking. Number 14. Wild rice. Wild rice contains approximately 1.5 times as much protein as other long-grain rice varieties, including brown rice and basmati. 1 cooked cup provides 7 grams of protein, in addition to a good amount of fiber, manganese, magnesium, copper, phosphorus, and B vitamins. Unlike white rice, wild rice is not stripped of its bran. This is great from a nutritional perspective, as bran contains fiber and plenty of vitamins and minerals. Number 15. Chia seeds. Chia seeds are derived from the Salvia hispanica plant, which is native to Mexico and Guatemala. At 6 grams of protein and 13 grams of fiber per 1.25 ounces, chia seeds definitely deserve their spot on this list. What's more, these little seeds contain a good amount of iron, calcium, selenium, and magnesium, as well as omega-3 fatty acids, antioxidants, and various other beneficial plant compounds. They're also incredibly versatile. Chia seeds have a bland taste and are able to absorb water, turning into a gel-like substance. This makes them an easy addition to a variety of recipes, ranging from smoothies to baked goods and chia puddings. Number 16. Nuts, nut butters, and other seeds. Nuts, seeds and their derived products are great sources of protein. 1 ounce contains between 5 to 7 grams of protein, depending on the nut and seed variety. Nuts and seeds are also great sources of fiber and healthy fats, in addition to iron, calcium, magnesium, selenium, phosphorus, vitamin E and certain B vitamins. They also contain antioxidants, among other beneficial plant compounds. Number 17. Protein-rich fruits and vegetables. All fruits and vegetables contain protein, but the amounts are usually small. However, some contain more than others. Vegetables with the most protein include broccoli, spinach, asparagus, artichokes, potatoes, sweet potatoes and Brussels sprouts. They contain about 4 to 5 grams of protein per cooked cup. Protein deficiencies among vegetarians and vegans are far from being the norm. Nonetheless, some people may be interested in increasing their plant protein intake for a variety of reasons. These 3 video series can be used as a guide for anyone interested in incorporating more plant-based proteins into their diet. Like this video, and give your valuable suggestions on what topic you want your video to cover next. Also, I am providing a free guide on how to start intermittent fasting to lose weight rapidly. If you are interested in that, click the link below and fill in your information. See you guys soon.